You are listening to the Faith Fight Podcast. Today's episode is on sharing your testimony. Hello again, everybody. Thank you for tuning in to this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I'm your host, Chris Creary, and I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. I'm grateful that you took time out of your day to listen to this episode, and I'm praying and I'm hoping that you'll be blessed by it. Today, we're going to talk about sharing your testimony. If this is your first time listening, you can subscribe to the podcast so you can get every episode that I release on a Monday morning. Also, I want to remind everyone that I have an archive of over 100 episodes available that you can download that covers a variety of different topics and situations that you may be going through right now. So if you need any help to find Bible verses or promises of God to stand on, or to agree with me in prayer as I pray for that specific topic for that episode, you can go into the archives, scroll through the different titles, and you can download any episode that you need to listen to. Because as the Word of God says, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. And you can listen to the podcast and subscribe through Apple Podcasts, through Google Podcasts, Amazon Music, through Audible, and also Spotify. So if you listen to podcasts using any of those apps, all you need to do is search for the Faith Fight Podcast, and you'll be able to subscribe to the podcast through any one of those apps. Now, just before we get into this episode, there's something that I just want to share with everyone. Now, I've been podcasting for over 2 years now, have over 100 episodes, thousands of downloads, and those are potentially thousands of lives that have been touched by this message of the Faith Fight Podcast. Now, one of the things that people have asked me time and time again is, Chris, I want to start my own podcast. How do I do it? What do I need to do? What do I need to download? What's the first step? What kind of microphone should I use? Etc., etc., etc. What I've decided to do this year is help you start your own podcast. So if you have a message that you want to share, if you're a pastor or a leader in your church and you want to share your own message out there to the world in the format of a podcast, I want to help you do it. But if you don't have a ministry and if you just want to talk about football or sports or automobiles, which are things that I love, by the way, and you want to start a podcast, I want to help you do that as well. What I did was I created a podcast quick start guide that you can download and you can read it through, and it'll give you the exact things that you will need to do in order to start your own podcast. And believe me, people, once you read the quick start guide, you will see it's not as difficult as you think. The link to get the podcast and quick start guide is in the description of this episode. Just click it and then you'll be able to download it, and you can read it through, and you can start getting your message out there to others. This is one of the things that I'm doing for 2021. I want to help other people start their podcast. So there's a link in the description of this episode that you can click on if you want to start your podcast this year in 2021. And believe me, it's not as challenging as you may think. The link is below if you want to download that and see for yourself. But now back to this episode. So if we keep all the good that God has done in our lives to ourselves, then it would be that much harder to spread the good news about Jesus to others. The fact is that sharing your testimony to others is essential to successful Christian living. It is also one of the easiest ways to testify to others of how good God has been to you. So let's get into this episode today about sharing your testimony. And as we go through this episode, I'm praying that God will show you who you can share your testimony to, that it will be a blessing to them after they hear your story. So the first verse that we're going to read is Daniel 4, verse 2. It says, "It has seemed good to me to show the signs and wonders that the Most High God has done for me." So as your prosperity increases, remember to share what God has done for you. Share the miracles that you have experienced so that the world and unbelievers will know what God has done. These verses come right after God delivered the three Hebrew boys from the fiery furnace in Daniel chapter 3. Next, I'm going to read 1 Peter 3 verses 15 to 16. It says, "But in your hearts honor Christ the Lord as holy, always being prepared to make a defense to anyone who asks for a reason for the hope that is in you, yet do it with gentleness and respect, having good conscience, so that when you are slandered, those who revile your good behavior in Christ may be put to shame. So God is not looking for spectators, but for those who will live for their King with righteousness and give testimony about Him with gentleness and respect. You need to remember that when you give your testimony, always do it with gentleness and respect to others. Now I'll read Revelation 12 verse 11. It says, "And they have conquered Him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, for they loved not their lives even unto death." Now, one way that we can have victory over the enemy is to share our testimony. The blood of Jesus makes us righteous, and since we are made righteous, there is no argument that can be made against us as we share our testimony with others. In addition to that, we can't be afraid of what others will think or say of us when we share our testimony. So just be bold and share your testimony when the opportunities arise. Next, I'm going to read Mark 5, verse 19. It says, "And he did not permit him, but said to him, 'Go home to your friends and tell them how much the Lord has done for you and how he has had mercy on you.'" So I would encourage you to read Mark chapter 5 in context, but given this man's past, he was probably a well-known person. Those who knew him needed to hear his testimony to know what happens when the kingdom of God comes into a person's life. The people in your life need to hear what Jesus has done for you, so you can use these verses as an encouragement for yourself to share your testimony with others. Next, I'm going to read Romans 10 verse 14. It says, "How then will they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe in him of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone preaching?" So we must take God's great message of salvation to others so that they can respond to the good news. How will your loved ones and your neighbors hear about Jesus unless someone tells them? Share what Jesus has done in your life to others today. Now I'm going to move on to the next verse for this episode. It is Luke 8:39. It says, "Return to your home and declare how much God has done for you." And he went away proclaiming throughout the whole city how much Jesus has done for him. Now again, I would encourage you to read Luke chapter 8 in context so that you can understand what exactly is happening in this verse. Now Jesus knew that this man would be an effective witness to those who knew his previous condition. When God touches your life, don't be afraid to share the wonderful events with your family and friends. And I'll read Psalm 66:16 next. It says, "Come and hear, all you who fear God, and I will tell you what he has done for my soul." Now the psalmist concludes by sharing his praise with the congregation for God's answer to his prayer. He confesses that his deliverance would not have happened if he had held on to sin in his heart. Now, sharing this kind of testimony with others is important because others can learn from your testimony and avoid the sin that you have just been redeemed from. And the final verse for this episode is Psalms 107, verse 2. It says, "Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he has redeemed from trouble." So God has done so much for us, and we have so much that which we can give him thanks for. He wants us to tell everyone all that he has done for us. So think back of all the good things that God has done and ask yourself, is there someone that you can tell about God's goodness in your life today? And now it's time to pray concerning sharing our testimony. So if you're doing anything that requires your direct attention, keep your eyes open. I'm going to pray and you can agree with me through saying amen. So Heavenly Father, we just humbly thank you for your amazing grace and your mercies. And thank you, Lord, that we may enter before your presence with boldness and confidence by the blood of Jesus Christ, our Savior. And we come before you, Lord God, thanking you, Lord God, that we have a testimony. Thank you, Father, that you have cleansed us, purified us, and forgiven us from all our sin, Lord. And if there is anything right now, Lord God, that is separating us from you hearing our prayer, Father God, have mercy. mercy upon us now, Lord, and forgive us, Lord. And this in itself is such a great testimony, Father, that you have forgiven us and cleansed us from all sins. So this alone, Lord God, is worth telling our friends and families and sharing about to others, Lord God. This alone is a very powerful testimony that we can encourage others. So we thank you for all that you have done for us, Lord, to allow us to be in right standing with you. And Father, I pray for anyone out there who has been delivered, Lord God, from a life and death situation, Lord God, who has been healed, Lord God, or if you had provided anything for them, Lord God, whether large or small, Lord God, if there was any type of financial need that you met in their life, Lord God, Father, help us to remember these things where you have come through strong in our lives. And Father God, I pray that you would give us the courage and the boldness, Lord God, to share that testimony of that situation with others, Lord God, so that we may boast in our God, Lord God, so that we may lift you up, Lord God, and give you glory for the amazingly good things that you have done in our lives, Lord God. Give us the boldness and the confidence, Lord God, because we have been redeemed of the Lord, and we will say so, Lord God. We will tell the world, O God, the wonderful things that you have done in our lives, Lord God. So, Lord, I commit and I pray for every single person listening to this episode right now, Lord, that you will help us, Lord God. Give us the opportunities, Lord God, that we may share our testimonies, Lord God, with others, Lord God. Bring people, Lord God, who may not even know of who you are. Right now, Lord God, bring them into our path, Lord, that we may share our testimonies with them, that they may learn and know who you are, know who you truly are, Lord God, which is a loving Heavenly Father that desires to do good to his people, Lord God. So we thank you, Father God, for your amazing love for us, Lord God, and the testimony that you have in our lives, Lord God. We give you all the praise and the glory, and we ask that you watch over us and our families, Lord God, and continue the good work that you've started in our lives, Lord. I commit every single person listening into your watchful hands, and I thank you that you're perfect and amazing will be done in our lives, Lord God. And may you receive all the glory, Lord God, as we share our testimonies with others, Lord. And we give you the praise and the thanks for this. In Jesus Christ's holy name, we thank you and we pray. Amen. So that's a wrap for another episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. If you were blessed by this episode, share it with someone else so that they can listen and be encouraged and built up as well. And if you were blessed by this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast, go over to Apple Podcasts and you can subscribe and leave a 5-star review for the podcast and share your testimony there. You can write down what this podcast has done to encourage you and to help you to grow spiritually on Apple Podcasts. And for those of you who have Android phones, you can subscribe and listen to the podcast through Google Podcasts or Spotify. And again, the podcast is also available on Amazon Music and on Audible. And as always, I create a customized prayer plan for this episode with the Bible verses that I went through, the notes, and also the prayer plan for every single day of the week that you can follow and use it as part of your daily devotions. And that's all I have to say for this episode. Remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you will hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Be blessed, everyone.